Hello, today we're looking at Play on Linux 5.0 Alpha 1, and this is for me a major thing because since I started to become interested in Linux, I didn't see Play on Linux doing any major change. It's based on 1 as we all know, and this 5.0 is a big upgrade because recently, and I'm just gonna show you where to download the app. You will find the link in the description of this video, and recently with Steam getting huge in the process of playing all most Windows games on Linux with Lutris Uprise, and playing Linux kind of getting older and older, I thought it's like a program that was great at the time, and it's kind of faded. It's fading out. It's not living, it's just fading out. And then this week, Monday, they released an alpha client of the future of Play on Linux, and it's really, really awesome. Like, there's two clients which we can install, but only the one is working if you, the Java client, which is pretty, so I hope they fix it. And it's not yet good for installing apps. Like, it starts, but most of all it fail or it's very slow, so it's an alpha, so give it to them, but it gives us an idea of what they are doing, and that is amazing. So I'm going to open up a terminal in the directory where my file is. We first of all have to install Java 8, and all the version, it doesn't work with the new version. If you tried it on Ubuntu 8.4, and that's why you came here, you will have noticed it doesn't work if you don't install this package. So now, while this is running, I'm gonna go to copy the name of this package. I'm not just gonna write this name in my commands in the description of this video because I might, when you see this, it might be alpha 2 or beta, so who knows what's gonna be then. So that's why I'm making it easy to use. So I'm just gonna paste it here, that this next command is correct. And after the installation is done, you can remove this package. It's really fun. So as you can see, Java is still installing, and I'm gonna fast forward this part, and when it's done, I will see you again. Fantastic. As you can see, we're basically done here, and it's been quite a while, and it's a lot of stuff happening here. But done and done means it's all done. And then we're gonna copy the next command. So it is just a lot of copy pasting, which is a fantastic thing. What I like about, as you can see, it tried to install, but it got a lot of dependencies that needs to be installed, so that's why we're gonna run this next command, which will install everything else. You can't miss one of these two, because otherwise it won't work. One thing I love about this release is they integrate Steam. Like, you're not needed to have Steam installed on your system, but they use Steam Play and all those good stuff, and they make like small installations for everything you need, and you will have it like technically in Play on Linux, but it uses Steam backbone, the Play on Linux backbone, to install and run the apps, which opens up a lot of opportunities. And they also got their Lutris, Steam, they are all games. They got Microsoft Office, Adobe Reader, things like that also inside of it. So you have more, it's a more complete package, which is fantastic. So as you can see, it is still running, and some of the apps they can download direct from the internet. Some you have to have the installation package on your computer, and some takes you to Steam and install it via that. So it's a bit of a mix up there, but it's fantastic. So if we close everything up, we can see what all the talk is all about. And I'll just stop in Play on Linux, and this kind of phone Onyx play on Linux. So it's a new icon already, and the HVLC is for Java, and the other one is a Python client, but the Python does not work at the moment, don't. Or I just don't know how to make it fix, but the Java is easy to run. And as you can see, apparently it looks all different and much better, much clearer, much more newer, and compared to the old Play on Linux 4 point something, this is really looks much, much better. It still takes a while for the games to load, but it is in the past also with the previous one, it was exactly the same problem. And as I said, most of the installations, all of them which I tried in fact, did not work. So don't you think everything will work, but it gives you a great idea of what they are doing. Look at the beautiful icons. You can install Age of Empires 2 HD, which is one of the best games ever created, according to me, and it will install it for Steam, but it will feel all like you play on Linux. You got Adobe. You got so many games. You got League of Legends. I wonder if Fortnite is here. We're gonna testing require patch. No, Fortnite is not there. Oh well. And as I said also, you can find Office here. Old games. I don't know if they still have to clean up the old library. Because they got all these games, but I don't know if they can all work, because I tried them all, they don't work at the moment. But I don't know if it's just because it's an alpha, or because they got too much things and they still have to clean up. And they got Microsoft Office 2010 and 2013 here. It's fantastic. Then you got your containers, you can create containers, you can choose your Wine version installation. When you install a package, it will happen here. And settings. So I love the idea. I think it's a brilliant idea, and it's really cool. And it's like really talented, and I think they've done a great job. And I think I will continue to look at it. And whenever something is new out, I will come back to you with it. Thank you for watching. See you later. Please subscribe. Please like this video. Please share this video. And if you want to support this channel, but you've already subscribed, please try out the Grassman Small Business Grassman Small Business Backup. It is unlimited, it is highly secure, it is beautiful, and it's only $10 per month per device. And if you sign up for the 1 free month trial version, you are truly, truly supporting this channel even more than you can imagine. So if you have time, please check it out, and see you later. Goodbye.